We are going to review today Sony Xperia Z smartphone. This is the first smartphone to be launched under Xperia series, which is also said to be one of the best models by Sony until they have finally launched Xperia ZR. So it is a kind of a phablet that comes with a 5-inch screen, which is a full HD reality display. It has a very sleek and stylish design. And it comes packed with rich features. Xperia Z is one of the strongest competitor for the high-end devices in the market like HTC One or Samsung Galaxy S4. It comes with Android 4.1 Jelly Bean OS. It is powered by 1.5 GHz quad-core Qualcomm APQ8064 processor. It has 2GB RAM, and the performance of this device is smooth and lag-free. The integrated Andreno 320 GPU makes it more powerful in terms of running any HD video game on it. In terms of battery, it runs on 2330mAh battery, which is a bit weaker compared to 3100mAh battery used in Galaxy Note 2. Overall, Sony has worked really hard on this device to make it perfect in terms of overall performance and output, and also the price of this device lies around Rs. 38,000. However, you can find the same on Flipkart for 36,850 at a discounted rate. Compared to other devices, this one is more durable. It is a waterproof device with dust-resistant design, which makes it more powerful. You can freely use it underwater, pool, rain, or anywhere without worrying. The prime highlight of this device is it has an Android 4.1 Jelly Bean OS, which is upgradable to Android 4.2. The front 5-inch screen is a full HD reality display with mobile Bravia engine 2. The maximum resolution you can get on this screen is 1920 by 1080 pixel. It has a 1.5 GHz quad-core processor, which is a Qualcomm APQ8064 CPU, 2GB RAM, and Adreno 320 GPU. It comes with dual camera, where the back camera is a 13-megapixel camera with LED flash and XMOR RS sensor, while the front camera is 2.2 that offers you a 720 pixel of video recording output. It is waterproof and dust-resistant. It has the internal memory of this device is 16GB. You can see this here, where you get around 11.73 GB in usage. It supports 4G LTE, 3G. It has a Wi-Fi support. It has a Bluetooth GPS NFC feature, while the battery used inside this device is 2330mAh. Without any physical buttons in the front and back, Xperia Z looks quite attractive in full black packing. You can see the design of this device. The weight of this device is only 146 grams, which makes it very lightweight to carry, and also it offers a comfortable grip. The front side and the back side is covered with a shatterproof glass, and even after having a glass body on both the side, it is not at all slippery even if you hold it with a wet hand. The edges here are covered with a surrounded with a plastic material with rubber edges that add more to the grip. And overall, Xperia Z is having a quite awesome finish that makes it very rich in look. Compared to Galaxy S4, Xperia Z is quite bigger in size, which does not really matter because you're getting a much bigger screen here. This device is a waterproof device, and all the ports on side come covered with flaps. There are flaps over it. You can see this here. All ports are covered with flaps. So you can see all the flap covers here. So just to protect the device from water and dust, you can see that Sony has added all flap covers over each and every connector. You have to open this up even to insert a memory card or a SIM card on it. There are no physical buttons available on the front screen. There is also no camera button. Everything, whatever you have to do through this touch screen. The front screen is a 5.5 inch full HD screen, which is a Bravia Engine 2 display that offers you a lifelike picture output. On the top side, you can see a 2.2 megapixel camera that offers you HD recording, also an LED indicator which blinks when there are some notification. At the top side, there is a 3.5mm headphone jack. and a flap that protects it from water. While at the bottom you have nothing, there's just the serial key, serial number mention of this device. While on the right side we have a silver color, this is a round silver color power button. This is also the screen lock key, and just next to that is a SIM card slot. While below that lies the volume key and speakers at the bottom. While on the left we are having a micro SD card slot, which is also covered with a flap cover, and above that lies a micro USB connector which can be used for charging as well as which can be used for transferring data from device to PC and PC to device. So as you can see, the overall design is quite impressive with protective flap covers on all the side. At the back side, there is a 13 megapixel camera with LED flash and Xperia logo in the center. Overall, Xperia Z is quite attractive and stylish, and it has a very solid finishing. The device remains device has successfully passed a number of drop tests and water tests, and also a 130 degree chocolate test. So you can simply imagine that how durable this device is. Sony Xperia Z comes with 5-inch Full HD Reality Touchscreen display, which is very smooth in performance. The mobile Bravia engine too is quite vibrant in giving high quality image output, image and video output. You can see the image output here, the color detailing and everything is very nice here. This display offers you a maximum resolution of 1920 by 180 pixel, which is equivalent to HD flat screen TV. To make it more brighter, sharper and better in display, it offers you 441 PPI, which is exactly the same that we get in Samsung Galaxy S4. So if we compare iPhone 5 with this device, it offers you 324 PPI. And the same with HTC One, which offers 469 PPI. So in terms of display output, Xperia Z is quite better and offers you crystal clear viewing experience from any angle. You can see the display is not fading out from any output. The output is quite clear. Due to which you can simply enjoy a lot of videos, pictures, games, etc. on this. You can also go for web surfing, read ebooks on this, and the display will give you comfortable reading experience, which is exactly the same that we get in Samsung Galaxy S4. So if we compare iPhone 5 with this device, it offers you 324 PPI. And the same with HTC One, which offers 469 PPI. So in terms of display output, Xperia Z is quite better and offers you crystal clear viewing experience from any angle. You can see the display is not fading out from any output. The output is quite clear. Due to which you can simply enjoy a lot of videos, pictures, games, etc. on this. You can also go for web surfing, read ebooks on this, and the display will give you comfortable reading experience. Apart from HD resolution and high PPI, the Bravia Engine 2 technology makes the screen move better and vibrant it look. For multimedia, the color output is quite great here. You can see a sample video output which is quite clear. Inside settings, you can find an option to disable mobile Bravia engine, which simply enhance the video and for image output. You can see mobile Bravia engine 2 here. You can simply turn it off if you don't want it. Now the question arises here is about the durability of the screen. Now ample of you might be thinking that this device has a Gorilla Glass as a protective layer over the touch screen, but it does not have that. It is having a more superior glass, which is Asahi Dragon Trial glass. This is more thicker, lighter and harder than Gorilla Glass. In fact, this glass is one of the best in the market that is available on this screen. As per certain tests, this glass is capable of surviving 64 kg of weight, and still it remains unbreakable. So simply you can imagine how strong the display is. And also due to waterproof and dust resistant quality, this mobile becomes one of the best durable mobile in the market. Sony Xperia Z comes packed with Android 4.1 Jelly Bean OS, which is the latest Android operating system, and as per the hardware config, this can also be upgraded to Android 4.2. We can expect the update really soon on this device, where we can get 4.2 Jelly Bean with more better features. The update right now is available in 5 different countries, and in India we are waiting for that. Right now the existing interface is simply smooth and better, and there is no lagging performance here. The output is really great. You can see the icons here, which are optimized. It is having an optimized version of Android OS. Then this is the notification panel, which is very basic and simple. At the top side, you have few accessibility options. While there is more on the lock screen, you can see the visual blind effect, which make the lock screen more interactive, while there are some additional options also available. When you swap it from left to right, you can see you get an additional menu where you can simply start up the camera without unlocking the screen. While if you talk about the notification panel, which I had shown you earlier, we have a very few things available here. We have some few set of widgets available on the top side, through which you can simply control the volume, the Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, mobile data, and you can directly go in the settings panel. Whatever notification updates coming on your email or in the SMS or on your Facebook application comes in this section. The home screen of Sony Xperia Z is also very easy to customize. There are ample of new options available and some eye-popping graphics on the screen. To add a widget, you just have to tap the screen for some time, and you can see there is a separate panel that appears on the bottom, where there are four columns available, among which one is widget. This column offers you a set of useful widgets that you can put on the home screen, like for example clock. Even after tapping on the clock, you can find more different number of formats available, where you just have to tap on it and it appears on the screen. In the same way, there are some nice widget available for contacts, email. You can also check out your Facebook status directly through the Facebook widget. There is a dedicated widget available for Google Plus. While you can see there is a recent call widget available that gives you information about calls that you have attended recently. There is a social friend widget available that keep you updated about your Facebook details, Facebook post. So these are some smart widgets available in the home screen that you can use. While the next section is app section, where you can add an application on the home screen. Whatever you install in your device appear in this section. You just have to tap on it. The third one is to change the wallpaper. You can see these are the internal wallpaper of this device. While you can simply select an album, you can select from live wallpaper also. You can also choose a quick wallpaper. The last section here is theme. Now there are some set of pre-configured themes available in this inside this device, where you can simply select by tapping on it, and the themes on the background changes automatically. Along with this, it also applies the widget and home screen wallpaper. So in this way, you can see the home screen customization is extremely easy, and also you have option to resize the widget. When you tap on it for some second, you can see there is a square box appear on the top side. You have to drag it to reduce the size and to increase it. This is quite similar to HTC Sense, which also provides the same kind of feature of widget resizing. Xperia Z UI and Android 4.1 is well optimized, that offers you great performance when you are adding different set of widgets and application on the home screen. Customization options are much better here. There are a set of several useful applications available in this device, which are the Walkman, which is the default music player, a video player, DLNS streaming, PlayStation Store, etc. I'll tell you about the preloaded application later on. As now, Xperia Z is a good smartphone that comes with a nice optimized version of Android, good pre-installed applications, and also better hardware configuration. You will surely get 100 or more reasons to buy this device once it get update for Android 4.2. Xperia Z comes with power pack specification that offers you a 1.5 GHz of quad core processor. It has a good RAM internal and also a powerful GPU, due to which you get a very smooth lag-free performance. Due to Andreno 320 GPU, you can play almost any kind of HD game on this device, while this device has also gained a really good marks on benchmarking test. While performing a benchmarking test on GL benchmark for gaming, it offers a 30 FPS that is quite impressive. So the specification of this device is quite near to Nexus 4, but still this device has not scored really well in under benchmarking. This is the score that we got on AnTuTu benchmark. Even after having such a great hardware configuration, I really did not face any problem while using this for almost a week. There is a bit heating issue in this device while playing game. For example, if I play game for more than 10 to 20 minutes, there is a heating issue on this phone, but that looks to be normal. Anyways, heating is one of the most common issue in many devices, but for web browsing, for chatting, etc., this device is quite great. For videos also, it is it offers a great resolution. This device is capable of running all type of HD game and of giving you a hassle-free multitasking performance. Sony Xperia Z goes in the list of a few fastest smartphones which are available today in the market. We already know that Sony is one of the best among providing better sound quality since Sony Ericsson Walkman series smartphone. Now in this we are having the same Walkman application back with more enhancement. The sound quality is quite better here. You can see this is the audio application of this device. You can see there are two sections available here, among which under My Music you can find a set of different albums available. This My Music section gives you a listing of all songs which are inside the device, which are on SenseMe network, SenseMe channel, and which are on a DLNS server. Everything is listed in the same section. While you can simply configure a media server through this part, you have to tap on the settings icon on the top side. Go to media server. When you turn this on, the multimedia content of this device will be available for other devices. You can also add them. You can register those devices so that only they can access the content, other cannot. So in this way, you can convert this portable smartphone to a media server. While under settings, there are ample of different options available, like you can simply enable clear audio that enhance the audio output, and there are some sound enhancement setting available, which is a kind of an equalizer. You can see the options here. It is quite easy to use. You can simply modify the sound setting as per your need. You can configure clear bass, which add more sound effect. There are some set of different options, pre-configured preset available here, which you can choose. For example, you can simply tap on bass boost, or you can simply tap on treble boost to get the right kind of sound output. This is the playing section which show you the current music. There is another settings panel available here that gives you more options. For example, you can tap on throw, and you can simply play the same audio on a Bluetooth speaker or on a headphone, or you can add more devices through this section. While you can simply go to visualizer and you can add a bit of effect while playing the music. So this is the first device that I had seen which comes with an integrated visualizer. There are different options available here. You can see the theme section. You have to tap on it and you have different set of effects available. Also, the audio output on speaker is quite great. It is quite easy to hear also. Also, the speaker output of this device is quite great. this is the maximum audio output of this device, and you have a different set of album available in the device, so you can simply use the player itself to tap it toward the left side to scroll through different audio. There's one more options available which give you more information on the music. For example, you can find the related video on YouTube. You can simply collect some ringtones or some free download associated with that music from Play Now option. You can search for that artist, etc. So this was the Walkman audio player of this Sony Xperia Z, which is more better and has more enhancement right now. So now we will test out the video output of this device. It is having an internal integrated video player, which is capable of giving you a HD video output and a lag-free performance. Due to mobile Bravia engine 2, the output is simply great here. Now you can see this is the display panel of video player, where you can see at the back, at the lower part, it is capable of capturing metadata, which gives you more information on the video. There are additional settings available in the video player also that I had shown you in Walkman. For example, the same throw button that allow you to play the audio on a Bluetooth speaker or a headset. In the same way, you can simply share the same video with your friends on different sharing options available. At the bottom, you can see there are two more settings, among which one is sound setting. These are additional sound enhancement options available, where you can enable surround sound. You can simply enable clear stereo, clear face, X loud, that increase the volume of video, and dynamic normalizer. All these settings are also available in the audio player. But the last one is display setting, that take you to the settings panel under display section, where you can enable and disable mobile Bravia engine 2. So this is the video output of Sony Xperia Z. Sony Xperia Z has a completely new design photo gallery. You can see the album section here. This application offers you a simple way to organize all the photos that you had captured. Also, it arranges it in the form of albums. It also features options called that Sense Me slideshow, through which you can simply play a sample slideshow of all the photos with background music. You can select item, you can choose a set of photos for slideshow. You just have to tap on Sense Me slideshow, and you can see there are different options available at the bottom, from music you can add your own favorite music, or you can simply stick with the default one. While under themes, you can set a different set of theme option, in which the slideshow will change the photos. This is the Sense Me slideshow feature of this device. In this way, you can add as many photos as you want, and you can view them in a more proper manner. While you can simply enable a media server in this device, and you can share the same photos with other devices also. For gaming and multitasking, this device is quite great. It offers you a lot of multitasking feature. You can see there are tons of applications working in the background, and still the phone is not lagging nor it is freezing. It is working really nice. For gaming, you can install almost every HD game on this device. It is powered by a 1.5 GHz quad-core processor, a 2GB RAM and Adreno 320 GPU, that makes it very well in terms of gaming output. I'll play a small game here, which is NFS Most Wanted. This is not really a high-end game, but a mid-range high-end game, and still needs a good graphic card to work. So in terms of gaming, you do not need to worry about anything. You can simply install any HD game from Google Play. We'll just play a small demo of NFS Most Wanted, and we'll see the gaming output.
बारिश नहीं हो रहा
Now this is Need for Speed Most Wanted. You can see the games worked really well on this. So this kind of games work really fine on this device. Sony Xperia Z is one of the best choice for photographers as it offers you amazing camera features. It has a dual camera where a 13 megapixel camera lies on the backside with LED flash. The camera output is quite great here, where you can use the camera for video recording that offers you a maximum resolution of 1080 pixel, while the same for photos when you want to capture high quality photos. You can get a maximum resolution of 3920x2204. Also, you can extend the resolution up to 3920x2940. So here, this camera is capable of giving you some really high quality photos. Also, the front facing camera is quite enough, which is a 2.2 megapixel camera, giving you a proper output for video calling. You can get best quality images in light environment, while indoors with the help of flash also you can capture decent photos. For video recording, as I said, it offers you 1080 pixel output and 30 frames per second, which is quite amazing for a smartphone. There are ample of interesting features available in the camera. You can see the camera looks a bit decent with the set of options available on the left side. This is the settings panel that allow you to change different set of options of this camera. You can modify the resolution, you can set up a timer, you can simply adjust the exposure volume, or you can enable and disable HDR here. While there are more options available on the top side, where you can see the set of different modes available. These modes are actually a kind of setting, like the normal mode where you can capture more brighter photos. You can see the output here. In the same way, there is a video camera mode that allows you to capture videos. There is a burst mode available through which you can capture a set of multiple photos at a single time, so that you can get the perfect shot. While there is a picture perfect mode available. Now in this mobile, you can see there is a preview mode where you can see a set of different picture effects. So this is one of the cool features of this smartphone. You can see there are a set of different options available here. You can simply tap on anyone and you can get that kind of picture effects on your screen. Also, there is a panorama mode available. You can go with the scene selection to choose a different type of scene mode here. Like you can go for anti-motion blur, you can go for backlight correction, HDR, soft skin, etc. The camera of this device is extremely great with lot of features in it, due to which you can capture rich quality photos and through different mode. Now we will talk about the integrated application of this device which come pre-installed in it. You can see, as I showed you before, for audio you are having a Walkman. There is an album in it which offers you Sense Me slideshow. There is a video player also available. Now there is a Sony Select application available that allow you to that provide you suggestion for application or games that will work well on this device. In the same way, you have Track ID. This application comes in many Sony devices. This application allow you to find a song info. You just have to tap the center button and have to play the music. You can find the information about that song instantly. There's a Play Now options also available. This is a kind of an app store that offers you a number of different application, games, lot of ringtones and free stuff for this device. It works on Wi-Fi. In the same way, there is one more pre-installed application available, which is Movie Studio. Now this application allow you to create your own movie through different effects here. It is not really effective, but it allows you to merge two different video with each other. You can see you can simply import a video clip from the phone itself, or you can simply record a video, or you can also take a photo here. So this is a quite impressive application here for making your own videos. There's a Sony Smart Connect application also available that allow you to connect this device with different Sony devices, like to a Sony TV or a headset or etc. You can manage different set of profiles here, where you can simply tell the phone how to use the headphones or etc. So this is one of our most common application that we find in Sony devices. There's an additional car mode available here, which help you to use the phone more effectively when you are driving. You don't have to keep the phone on your ears, because when you are driving, you have to take precautions. You can enable car mode here, and you can check out the default options available. For example, you can simply use a navigation feature. You can run a media. You can also attend a call. Now, for improving the navigation features, it has a Voice Pilot application which is built for Xperia. This application allows you to locate your favorite destination. You can simply go on map. You can simply add. You can simply find location, person, etc., which are using the same kind of application. Also, there is an application available called a Social Life, which works with the widget that is available on the desktop. This application keeps update about your social networking platform and give you real-time updates on your home screen itself, like PlayStation Mobile. This is another great app for Xperia Z. Which offer you to play PlayStation games on your mobile or on HDTV via this device. You can see there are some set of different games and application available on this. You can choose a different set of games also from this section, and you can enjoy them on your device. Another helpful application here is Xperia Link, which is also a pre-installed application. It allows you to connect your device to your tablet or to your PC internet. You have to run a proper setup here. It is a kind of a tethering application, while App Extra is a kind of an app store for this device to get some extra applications. You can see there are some different set of sections available, like utilities, store market. You can get a lot of real-time updates from this place. Xperia Z comes with 16 GB internal storage, which is quite enough for storing thousands of music and images in it. Also, you can add some HD movies. But if you feel if you still feel that the storage is not enough, you can add a micro SD card slot. You can add up to a 64 GB of micro SD card slot on it. In terms of storage, this device is quite similar to HTC One, which is also having a similar storage, but it is not having a expandable memory card slot. So, and other connectivity options this device offer you is 4G LTE, 3G Wi-Fi, Wi-Fi Direct, Bluetooth, GPS and NFC. So for connectivity, this device is having ample of option that you can use to connect with other devices, and also the performance is quite smooth here. This connectivity option, it also support USB on go. With the help of an OTG cable, you can use different set of devices on this smartphone, like keyboard, mouse, PlayStation, joystick, etc. In terms of battery, this phone is running on 2330 mAh battery, which is a bit higher compared to HTC One S, which has a 2300 mAh battery. But also, it is lesser than Galaxy S4, which is having 2600 mAh battery. The battery life of this device is quite great. It works really fine on 2G and 3G. You can simply use different set of applications that collect real-time update, like Facebook chatting, WhatsApp, WeChat, etc. And still, the battery works quite enough. The battery output can be expected around 10 to 12 hours, which is more than enough for this device. Even after playing games on this device, watching videos, etc., still it is capable of giving a good battery life. Under settings, you get an additional power management option that allow you to save your battery more. You can see there are different options available here, where you can enable and disable ample of things. So this is a quite useful utility available here that allow you to enhance your battery life. Xperia Z stands very well among all the smartphones in the market in terms of durability. It is waterproof, dustproof, and offers you a great great durable design due to which you can simply carry it anywhere with you. And also in terms of cost, this device is a bit cheaper. The Galaxy S4 comes here for 39,500 and HTC One comes for ₹43,500, while compared to them, this Xperia Z device is available for ₹36,850. So among them all, this is more cheaper and more durable device with a 5-inch vibrant display and a HD resolution. Xperia Z is a kind of an ideal device that works really well for movies, for HD videos, for gaming, etc. There are also many important features available in this device, like a media server, a PlayStation mobile application, a great 13 megapixel camera with LED flash, etc. And lots of enhancement feature. Also, like compared to other devices, you can simply use this device. Also, you can enjoy the device underwater, in rain, in swimming pool, without worrying about any damage or about liquid issue. The performance is quite smooth. It has a great multitasking output. Xperia Z stand as one of the best devices among other devices in the market in terms of durability. It has a great durable design due to which it is waterproof and dustproof. And also in terms of price, this device is far more cheaper compared to other one, like Galaxy S4, which comes for ₹39,500, and HTC One that comes for ₹43,500. This device comes for ₹36,850, which is lot more cheaper. And also with a 5-inch HD display, lots of enhancement feature make this device an ideal smartphone. There are important connectivity features available in this. It offers you a direct media server option. It has a PlayStation mobile app and a 13 megapixel camera on the backside, allow you to capture unmatched quality of videos and images. Other than this, you can enjoy the device underwater, in rain or in pool, etc. You don't have to worry about any issue on this device. You just have to take care that all the flaps on the connector on the port should be closed properly. It offers you a smooth performance, and it is better for multitasking. It also offers you great gaming performance. There are a lot of customization options available on this device, due to which you can simply make the device look as you want. Overall, I can say this is one of the best durable high-end phone in the market at a reasonable price. The positive aspect of Sony Xperia Z is sleek design, comfortable grip. The material used on the body is quite better and durable. It has a very sharp and bright display. The waterproof and dustproof qualities, smooth performance and multitasking with optimized user interface, 13 megapixel camera with 1080 pixel recording, ample of preloaded application which are quite useful, and very impressive battery life. But the negative aspect of this device is there are fingerprint marks easily appear on the display, while the front camera is not so good in indoors for capturing photos.
That's all for now. For more review, tutorial, news and updates on latest technology, visit techrina.in. Thank you. Have a nice day.